guys, welcome back to another episode. This one we're exploring another dam around Collie, and then we'll head south. We went to Gnomesville,
got eaten by march flies,
and went on to Margaret River, where we used that as a base to explore.
We headed down to Hamelin Bay, which I've always wanted to go to, and it didn't disappoint. We even had two unexpected visitors while we were there, which we will share with you. And then we popped down to Augusta while we're there as well.
And then we added another little gadget to the Everest, so we'll take you through that, show you that. And we also drew the winner of our Olight torch, so stay tuned for that as well.
Let's get into it. Look at that parking. How crooked that is. Well, I was trying to get you straight on those poles. You just unstraightened yourself. I had you straight. Now you're not straight again.
I reckon this is straight when you're parallel with the poles.
You're not though. You were more parallel before you moved.
Of course. You want me to get the tape measure out?
You're now... The back of it is now crooked and you were straight.
That's fine. I'm happy with that right now.
We've just arrived at Lake Kepwari, just out of Collie. Chris is just setting up after we finally got the caravan straight. So we booked site 2. We didn't actually have a lot of choice because this place is quite popular, so it was the only site that we could get for the whole amount of time that we wanted to be here. So we don't actually know where the lake is. Apparently there's a lake around here somewhere. Hopefully not too far away, but definitely not close to where our site is. I'll just quickly walk you back. This is the entrance. We're literally only, I think it was 15 k's out of Collie, or maybe 2.5 hours from Perth. So nice and close if you live in Perth to come down. Yeah, this is the signs. Oh, here we go. Site 2, okay, yeah, so we're quite far from the water, but that's okay. Good exercise. So that's us up. Up there. And as you can see, it's middle of summer, so no fires, unfortunately. We have to wait till winter. It's a bit cooler for fires. Yeah, so this is Lake Kepwari. Well, the parking, the camping spot anyway.
Very hot here, not much wind.
I found us on the map, we're very far from the water.
Yeah.
Well, it looks far on the map, whether it actually is. That bleep was Chris realising that there's march flies here, which have been a very common occurrence down around the Collie area. But they're still better than mosquitoes because we haven't seen any mosquitoes, which is great.
And they're dumb, so they're easy to kill.
That's not very animal friendly.
March flies don't count.
So this site only opened in 2020, so it's very new. As you can see, there's the bathrooms right next to us. They're all nicely planted. And this actually used to be an old coal mine, which they've repurposed to use for recreation, like water skiing and canoeing and all that stuff, which is pretty awesome. If you've got good, you can roll it out before you parked.
Yeah.
You'd have to listen to my reversing instructions.
Nah. So we're staying at Lake Kepwari, I think that's how you pronounce it. It's a pretty nice little spot. Set, booked campsites, massive campsites. You'd easy fit two vans on there. And they reckon you can have 12 people per site. Pretty cool. We're just heading down the lake to go for a swim. Got heaps of these cool little tracks. Walk down to the lake. Some of the sites here, they've got... their own little beach access. You just walk down the little track to the beach. Our one's a bit further away, but
good exercise.
Primo facilities here, boat ramp. There's a whole heap of like day use areas, little camp kitchens, I think they are. It's pretty cool. So this rocky area here's an overflow for when the dam's full. But that's the lake out there. Awesome lake. Go skiing.
If we had a boat.
If we had a boat. There's the whānau down there. Going down for a dip.
Ready for a swim, Rika?
Yes, of course.
What do you got there?
A baby Mary.
You gonna put him back in so he stays alive?
Baby Mary's.
Look, my mug, Daddy. I finished my mug.
That's pretty cool.
I think it's a piece of coal. Well, it's a coal mine, so you know, makes sense.
Yeah, skim. Show us your skills.
Skimmy rock.
What was that, two?
Three.
Intermediate level.
It's a piece of coal, it broke up.
After some of the caravans we just saw on that walk, she's a little pod.
It's only got a little tractor.
True. We finally went and picked up our Amtron solar blanket, 200 watt solar blanket, just to add to the what's on the roof, just so we can move it around if we're in the shade. And we've got it attached to one of the Anderson plugs that the boys put in, the 3D printer. We hit it at the front late yesterday when the sun moved, so the plug, having the plugs all around the caravan really helpful so far. And for those who have been asking about our solar, we got our highest wattage the other day. As you can see on screen, we went over 1,000 watts, and we also went over 70 amps. And that is excluding the solar blanket, which can give us another 11 to 12 amps. So we have power to burn, which is awesome.
Alright guys, we're just leaving Lake Kepwari. We've been here for 5 days. It's a primo little spot. Big campsites, easy fit two vans on there. Now we're heading into Collie, we're going to restock, and then we're on to Gnomesville. Go and show you the little gnomes. And our final destination is Margaret River. We booked into a holiday park there.
We're going to use it as a base and do a couple of day trips from there.
So we just pulled up at Gnomesville, check out all the little garden gnomes here.
There's lots of horse flies though.
Marchies are out of control. Just had our first fan notice us from YouTube, that was pretty exciting.
I don't know if you can say fan, but he recognised us. We've only ever had 10 people say that they've seen us after the fact, so it's the first time someone's actually come up while we've been here and said they recognised us. So that was pretty cool.
Seriously reducing population.
You're doing the marchy dance.
These things are making this place out of control. They do some march spraying.
Look at them all. Chris is still doing the march fly dance. They're pretty horrible. It's a shame. Makes you probably have a look around a lot quicker than you would if you weren't getting attacked by march flies. Trying to find all the funny ones. Papa Smurf has invaded the gnomes.
That's not Papa Smurf, is it?
Yeah. That's a little bit rude, but kind of funny. Old plate gnome, learning how to be a gnome. We found a fellow Kiwi gnome. Yeah. Hello, black family in New Zealand. Gnomeo and Juliet.
These dudes are complying. Got their masks on. Check this little dude out on his motorbike. Found a Kiwi gnome.
Another Kiwi.
Got
gnome.
The Tui hat on from Manga Tanoka. Oh, there's another Tui gnome poking out the keg. This dude here's got a good name. Reached the city limits.
We just finished at Gnomesville. We're only here for about 15 minutes, maybe. Probably not even that. The march flies were out of control, but we had a good look around, or as good as we could, and we found some pretty funny ones, which is cool. So,
definitely worth a stop if you're driving past, and it's pretty cool to see so many there and not too many damaged, like. That's pretty awesome.
And lots of countries represented, families, clubs, and it's free. There's no charge. There wasn't even a donation box. So, I mean, I would have been happy to give a donation if there was one here.
Yeah. We should have bought a gnome and left a lentil gnome.
Yeah, we should have had a lentil gnome. That would have been an awesome idea. Oh, well, next time. See you in Busselton.
Busso next, and then on to Margs. So we just stopped in at Busselton. We're just gonna make some lunch and then go for a quick walk down the foreshore, have a bit of a look around and then carry on to Margs.
We've arrived in Margaret River and we are staying at the RAC Margaret River Nature Park. So we're just gonna set up for the night and this will be our base for the next 5 days.
Hey guys, I've got a little gadget here from iCheck. They sent me out a tire pressure monitoring system. So we'll run through the install and I'll tell you what I think of it. So there's three different size kits. One's a five, you get five, so it's obviously four wheels and your spare. The other one's an eight for if you're towing a single axle trailer, for your two axles and your spare on your caravan. And the one that we got's a 10 because we got a dual axle caravan with the spare. So you got five on the car and five on the caravan. With the 10 kit, it's recommended that you buy a Bluetooth expander. We tried running it without it and it worked most of the time. It's just when you drove away from the caravan and came back, you had to reconnect it. But I think with the Bluetooth expander, it works much better. So the installation on these things is super easy. They're all numbered for their position. According in the instructions, there's a diagram, tells you where to put each cap. All you do is unscrew your dust cap on your wheel, push the little dust cover on, wind the locking nut on, and then screw the pressure monitoring device onto your valve. Tighten up the locking nut on the back, bring the dust cover forward, and that's it. It Bluetooths back to the in-cab screen, and we'll show you that now. So the in-cab screen is completely Bluetooth and it's also got a solar panel on top, so it doesn't even need a charging cable. It just stays charged with the solar. So on the screen you got your four tires. They show your pressure and your temperature. The temperature is the small number, and every 10 seconds it cycles from your 4 road tyres to your spare, and if you've got your caravan connected, it'll cycle to your caravan tyres and then to your caravan spare. And that happens automatically every 10 seconds. Or you can cycle through with the little buttons on top manually. Connecting was super easy. As soon as we turned this thing on, it hooked straight up to all the sensors on the tyres. It's got a function where you can disconnect the caravan when you go away, so it doesn't think your caravan tyres are flat. And it's also got an off-roading function where you can change your low and high set points so it doesn't go off when you got your tyres let down. So when you order your iCheck TPMS, it comes with a little silicone pad that sticks on the bottom. And it doesn't actually stick to your dash, but it's non-slip. I just sit it there and it hasn't moved. But you can put it anywhere. Obviously you have it on your windscreen so the sunlight can get to the panel. And I charged that when I first got it out of the box 2 weeks ago, and I haven't charged it since. The solar panel does a good job. So far we're really happy with the iCheck TPMS. We haven't done any super serious off-roading or anything like that. My valve stems are hidden in behind the dish on the rim, so I don't think there'd be any problems with them getting pulled off. But for touring, they're an awesome thing on the road to keep an eye on what's going on with you, especially your caravan tyres. So the iCheck TPMS would be really versatile if you had multiple trailers, like if you had a caravan and a boat trailer, you can swap the little things over before you go on your trip, so you can always keep an eye on your pressures of your trailer. Like we said at the start, there's the 5, the 8 and the 10 packs, depending on your configuration of your trailer. And if this is something that you guys are interested in, we've got a 10% discount code, LBW10. Jump over to iCheck's website, use that code, get 10% off, grab yourself a bargain, get one of these awesome little kits. They're pretty cool, so jump over, do some shopping.
Ready to go play with some stingrays, babe?
How many times have we stopped for roadworks lately?
Oh my god, so many times. All the time, everywhere you go. Come over
there. Is there? Go find some stingrays?
See if we can.
Oh, he's coming at you. His mind. Oh, it's coming in! Oh my god, he's coming at me. I don't want him to come at me. Hello, stingray. A bit close. Stingrays are really cool, but I don't want them to get too close to me.
You're gonna get tag teamed. Touch him?
I touched it.
Finally.
I felt like an eel. Yeah. A woman's work is never done. Ironing board on the beach at Hamelin Bay. Not too sure what that's all about. I'm sure there's a story. Here comes our favourite one. He's got no tail. So he can't kill us.
Oh, he's coming at my foot.
Oh,
my god, he's gonna bump into me. Hello, stingray. Touching him.
Type it is. It's definitely a shark. So now there's two sharks, two dark shapes.
And they're about as tall as me. They are weak sharks.
So I always tell Chris that when we are in the bush that it's a little bit snaky. We get to Hamelin Bay and it's a little bit sharky.
It's a lot sharky. We see more sharks than we have snakes.
And they're not little ones either.
It's a good size one.
Don't think they put that on the brochure.
Big enough to take your leg off anyway.
Heading up to the lookout to have a look over the bay after we've patted stingrays each. Find the sharks again. And there's people swimming. Clearly they don't like their body parts.
Just been down to Hamelin Bay with the stingrays. That was primo, so good.
Heaps of stingrays in all different sizes. And we didn't realize till the end there was different kinds as well. Three different kinds.
Saw a couple of sharks.
Some big sharks, not just little sharks, like don't want to swim sharks, even though there were people swimming.
But no, really good, really worth the trip. Doesn't take that long to get here from Margaret River either.
No, what was it, about 20 minutes?
Yeah, something like that.
Now we're off to Augusta. We have never been there before, so we'll go. I think we're just going to have a look around the town and around the estuary, see what it's all about. I think there's a lighthouse down there too, actually. Might be able to go look at that.
We've just arrived in Augusta, and as we were driving past the water, we saw some dolphins, so we've quickly stopped and we're just going to try and catch them on film again for you.
See, it's pretty rough where this open ocean comes in to the little bay. A big pelican there. He's trying to steal the fisherman's catch. It's a really pretty little town.
We came to see the lighthouse, but unfortunately it's under major repair and all we can see is scaffolding. Even though that was a bit of a bust, it wasn't a complete waste of trip, because just down the road from the lighthouse is a historic water wheel. Okay, you've made it to the end of the video, and we know you've been waiting for us to announce the winner of this little Batton 3 from Olight, and we are really excited to announce Sean Peters is our winner. He selected black, so a little black Batton 3 Olight is on its way to you shortly. Thank you everyone that entered. We got a heap of entries. please make sure you subscribe to our channel when you enter. We actually did draw this before, and the person that we drew wasn't a subscriber, so we've redrawn it. So just make sure you subscribe and comment when you enter these draws, and good luck for the next one.
So that's it for another episode. Thanks for joining us, thanks for watching. Make sure you like and subscribe our channel, share it with your friends so we can keep these giveaways going. Congratulations to our Olight winner. We'll be in touch, we'll get that out to you.
And we are now at our next location. So yeah, like Chris said, make sure you're subscribed and we'll share it with you in the next episode.
Thanks guys.
Thank you.